हेलो एवरीबडी, दिस इज़ मसूद अंसारी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी, यूपीएससी कॉलेज बरौनी। एज वी नो दैट देर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट, लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट, फील्ड एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड नेचुरल एक्सपेरिमेंट। इन द प्रीवियस टू वीडियोज वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड फील्ड एक्सपेरिमेंट। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेचुरल एक्सपेरिमेंट। सो वॉट इज द नेचुरल एक्सपेरिमेंट? Natural experiments are conducted in a real life environment of the participant. But there are experimenter has no control over the independent variable as it occurs naturally in the real life. So if we will compare between the lab experiment, field experiment and natural experiment, then we can understand the differences take place between these experimental methods. Now come to the previous experiments like lab experiment. In case of lab experiment, experimenter was able to control the extraneous variable and to manipulate the independent variable. While in case of field experiment, experimenter was able to only manipulate to the independent variable while he was unable to control extraneous variable. And in case of natural experiment, experimenter has no control over the independent variable and even he is unable to make constant the extraneous variable. So now come to an example conducted by Lizard and Hodge in 1989. Compare the long-term development of children. You can say that he conducted a longitudinal study in which he has selected 65 children who were brought up in the institutionalized care center. Now come to the strength of the natural experiment. First point is, behavior in a natural experiment is more likely to reflect real life because of its natural setting. Very high ecological validity. It means that natural experiment is conducted under the natural setting. There is no control over the independent variable or extraneous variable. That is why there is a high ecological validity as compared to lab experiment as well as field experiment. And second point is, there is less likelihood of demand characteristics affecting the result, as participants may not know they are being studied. When you can imagine, when a participant is unable to understand, he is not aware that he is being studied, then definitely he will do whatever he want to do. We can say he will behave in a natural way. There will be no influence of any external factor so that he can manipulate, he can modify, he can change his or her behavior. And next point is, natural experiment can be used in situation in which it would be ethically unacceptable to manipulate the independent variable, for example, researching stress. We can't create any such situation in which participants feel stressed. But in case of natural experiment, we can study only those individuals who are stuck in a stressful situation. So this is the benefit of natural setting, that we are not going to create any stressful situation, but we can study to those individuals who are experiencing stress. And limitation of the natural setting is, they may be more expensive and time consuming than lab experiment. Obviously it will be more time consuming, because if we are going to study a natural phenomena or any incident which is take place because of natural incident, then we have to follow, we have to go through the incident. We can't control, we have no control over the condition. As earlier in this natural experiment we have mentioned, I have mentioned that we have no control, or an experimenter has no control over the independent variable, and he is unable to make constant to the extraneous variable. So in this situation, it may be more time consuming and expensive too. Second point is, there is no control over the extraneous variable that might bias the result. Yes, there is probability. Because of extraneous variable, there may be some modification, some changes take place. Because experimenter has no control over the extraneous variable and independent variable as well. So if we will compare between the lab experiment validity, external validity, and natural experiments external validity, so we can say that yes, natural experiment has somewhat higher ecological validity as compared to lab experiment. Now come to the experiment conducted by Hortz and Tizard in 1989. The aim of the experiment were to investigate the effect of institutional upbringing. Now come to the example of the natural experiment. Hortz and Tizard conducted a study in 1989, and their aims were to investigate the effect of institutional upbringing on later attachment. While second point was to investigate the effect of deprivation on later social and emotional development. These were the objectives of the experiment conducted by Hortz and Tizard in 1989. Now come to the procedure, how they conducted this experiment. Hortz and Tizard followed the development of 65 children who had been in residential nurseries from only a few months old. So what is the independent and dependent variable in this experiment? Independent variable in this experiment was natural growth is the independent variable, and attachment or emotional and social development is the dependent variable. Next point is, the care provided was of good quality to the children, but carers were discouraged from forming attachment with the children, and this create deprivation. Carers who were taking care of the children were instructed that they are not allowed to establish the relationship or attachment with the children, and this instruction create deprivation among the children. By the age of 4, 24 children were adopted. Out of 64, 24 children were adopted, and 15 returned to their natural home. You can say restored. And the rest of 26 stayed in institution. Next point is, they were also compared with the control group who had spent all their lives in their own families. The control group was closely matched to the children in the experimental group. For example, in terms of number of siblings, home location or geographical area, parental occupation, position in the family, like first child, second child or third child, age of the child, gender, these all factors was tried to match by the experimenter, so that variation, heterogeneous factor can be reduced. Next point is, the assessment comprised interviewing the children, their parents, teachers, and the set of questionnaires. In the natural experiment, what the experimenter found. First point is, at 4 years of age, none of the institutionalized children had formed attachment. But by 8 years of age, those who were adopted had formed good attachment, and also their social and intellectual development was better than that of children returned to their own families. Those returned to their natural families or restored showed more behavioral problems and the attachments were weaker. Nevertheless, all those children who had spent their early years in institution were more attention seeking and showed some difficulties in social relationship, particularly with their peers. Some of those children were interviewed again at the 16 years of age, and they were compared with the new control group. As the original control group no longer matched the children in the adopted and the restored groups. Hoss and Tizard found that the adopted children still had good attachments with compared to favorably with the control children. Fewer restored children were reported as having good attachment, but the children who had been brought up in the institutional care had experienced most insecure and showed some difficulties in their later attachment. Consequently, we can conclude that the evidence that researchers were correct who emphasized the importance of the early years, but the effect of delay in the information of attachment do not necessarily persist into adulthood and lead to affectionless psychopathy. Indeed, loving relationships and high quality care are necessary to reverse deprivation effect. So this is the all about natural experiment, in which experimenter conducted a study outside of the lab, and he has no control over the independent variable, and he is even unable to control or make constant to the extraneous variable. So somewhat extraneous variables must have influence on the dependent variable, or you can say behavior of the children or attachment of the children who has been brought up in the care center. Only those children develop or bear some better qualities of attachment and emotional and intellectual development who were adopted by the different families. So thank you so much for your patience.